is a unicorn. Look at that. This is awesome. And what he does is beautiful, and how he does it's beautiful. And he's out there hitting it 340, and he's making it look like how Baryshnikov made dancing look.
What do you see there? This is good stuff.
No, it's not. I've always been an advocate of trying to make it more cohesive, and this is, you know, ripping that apart.
The thing about being outspoken on the PGA Tour is you kind of have to back it up.
Rory hasn't won a major in 8 years, and now there's more pressure than ever on Rory to actually go out and win.
St. Andrews, where golf's deepest roots lie in these lakes. From Old Tom to Tiger, the greats have shaped the history of the game here. The Open has come home, and there is simply no place like it.
I hit rock and roll, so you
can't hit higher than it.
Listen, when I start playing that way, we go. The club will put their films in touch. I mean, wait till all my top friends are here, okay?
St. Andrews is one of my favorite golf courses in the world. It's the holy grail of our sport.
Marvelous performances for you. This is a keeper with you around for a long time. You know, what
actually looked like a Ford, under the hood had a Lamborghini engine. I mean, he wins four majors out the gate pretty quick. And then it went from there.
I'm a champion golfer over here.
When you look at some of the reasons that the players decided to not take the money from Liv, I think it's the legacy. And the players like Rory and Victor Hovland and Colin Morikawa, who want to be the Hall of Fame next year.
That's how they see it.
It's a truly kingdom of as a 20-carat golden ring.
It's tough not to take care of your family, man. To know that my kids, my grandkids are taken care of. So, you know, now breaking away, going with Liv, I'm happy with the decisions I've made.
The Liv rumor mill is still very much alive and well here at St Andrews, with lots of talk of who might be next. The name I've heard mentioned more than once is Cameron Smith, a man who's played great golf lately. From Northern Ireland, Rory McIlroy.
Rory, of course, the leader in the world of golf and custodian of our game right now.
As well as the other tip of the cap to rewards Tiger from McIlroy.
And how many people years from now will claim to have been right there when he finished up at 18?
There's never going to be another Tiger Woods in our game for so many reasons. Not just his success in the golf course, but also the barriers that he was able to break down.
Tiger.
He set a great example for a lot of us going forward.
A very good morning to you and welcome. The man on top of the leaderboard going into the weekend, Cameron Smith, who leads the way, 13 under par. Two-shot buffer over Cameron Young, McIlroy, and Victor Hovland are in there as well.
With all the controversy and all the drama that's caused, it's hard not to look out at the greens here at St Andrews and see it as a metaphor for the whole PGA Tour versus Liv story. And at this historic major, it feels like a dramatic stage on which this battle is playing out.
The crowds are obviously very pro-Rory this week. What, on a personal level, do you like about Rory?
I've known Rory for a lot longer, I think, than most guys, and most people understand. You know, we met each other when we were 8 years old.
Yeah.
He's always been a really kind-hearted, kind of genuine person, and I just think that hasn't changed. He's opinionated, but I would have to say I agree with most of the things that he says. I think he's great for our game. The Dolphin world is probably wanting him to win.
When Rory is playing at his best, I don't know who can beat him. But it's been 8 years since Rory McIlroy has won his last major, and he has come very close at multiple majors. I don't know what else to call it except a drought.
Can he go back to back? Yes, he can.
Rory McIlroy, boy, he seems so comfortable this week. If he would win it, look back and go, yeah, makes sense.
Well, good morning. The record crowds are gathering this Sunday in Scotland for this final major championship Sunday and hoping to carry home the fan and betting favorite.
Rory McIlroy, he has said this is the one he would love to win the most.
The support that I've gotten this week has been absolutely incredible. It's unbelievably cool to have a chance to win the Open at St Andrews. I mean, it's what dreams are made of, but nothing's given to you, and I have to go out there and earn it just like I've earned everything else in my career.
Some in the energy of this crowd. This could carry Rory right through, or it could make him a nervous wreck.
Cam Smith to catch McIlroy.
He's amazing. Two putt birdie will be for Smith. That's five in a row.
And now he is the championship leader, just like that, Cameron Smith. Anybody see that coming? Never has he needed a birdie more than right here. Let's this one slip through his fingers.
2015 till his present day, 7 years. I've played a ton of really good golf.
Now the final four ahead for McIlroy.
But in those 7 years, he's done everything possible in the game apart from winning the Futures Championship. So I feel like I'm trying to win my first one again.
Well, it's not the shot he was looking for. Cameron Smith leads by one shot.
The 17th, most famous hole on the entire golf course. All depends on the bounce.
That's pretty impressive.
Yes,
here.
It was. Very well done.
This is going to be a really tough shot.
It's in the hole.
That's pretty impressive. Good touch.
Great touch. Crucial. Par putt.
Crucial. It's just stuck with the red. Oh well.
Alright, huge putt here for McIlroy.
If he makes this, this road hole will light up St. Andrews.
Oh, he's two putted every hole today. Nothing's gone in for him, and Cam Smith has run the tables on him.
Cam Smith.
Wow, he is the spoiler. I can't believe that he played like that today.
Now Rory has to make eagle to tie. He's going to need to hole it out from there. Over the Swilken burn. He's going to fill up this fairway behind McIlroy with one last stroke to try to capture this elusive major at the home of
golf. He's going to need magic here to force this to a playoff. And that will make Cam Smith an Open champion at St. Andrews.
How difficult do you think it will be to deal with the disappointment of
all that I need is the air that I breathe. All that I need is the thing that I need. And all that really matters is what matters to me.
Like,
and I really like them.
Continues to be mentioned to me this week about LIV Golf. What's your position? Are you interested? Is there any truth to suggestions that you might be signing?
I just won the British Open and you're asking about that. I think that's pretty not that good.
I appreciate that, but the question is still there. Are you interested at all? Is there any truth in that?
I don't know, mate. My team around me worries about all that stuff. I'm here to win golf tournaments.
There have been rumors swirling all week, and everyone in the room takes that to mean this guy's going. Cameron Smith leaving the PGA Tour, that would be different than almost anyone that has come before him. Because other guys you could dismiss as, oh, they're at the end of their career, or they're not really that relevant. Cameron Smith is clearly at the peak of his powers. LIV Golf may have a 2022 major champion. This is something that demands a serious response.
He's just come back from Scotland, and we want to have a super special day with Rory McIlroy! Welcome to a very special pop-up clinic. We're here for a wonderful foundation today, the Youth on Course, which allows juniors to play certain golf courses at only $5 a round. It puts golf within the reach of just about everybody.
I think what Youth on Course are doing and their initiatives and making golf more accessible to everyone, especially kids, is really important for, you know, keep the game moving forward.
Well, would you like
being
it to have
one of the faces of golf? I realize the responsibility I have. If I want the game that I love to be sustainable and want it to be played by future generations, the game needs to be pushed forward.
Okay, nice to meet you. Nice to meet you.
What
time
have you
got?
Six.
I've
got a 6-2.
Good choice. Okay, kids, let's go to work. Are we ready? Here we go. Not easy, this, by any means. Oh! Officially announced that Rory has managed to win this contest. Oh, Rory!
Nice job. I think when you reach this stature in the game, there's a responsibility that comes with that.
Good job.
I'll always remember when I won the US Open in 2011. Jack Nicklaus wrote to me and Arnold Palmer, and they said, you know, are in a place in the game where you have a responsibility to, you know, grow the game of golf and inspire others to take this game up, and, you know, happy that I could play some small part in furthering the sport and growing it.
All right. I'm going to try to transport you to Kiowa.
Okay.
See anybody? Hi. So that's my co-founder, Rob. He's in Austin.
Oh, sweet. How you doing?
Good to see you. This is unbelievable.
I think the traditions of the game are so good, but I think also the traditions of the game hold it back from being as good as it could be, especially in this day and age. tell I've been playing in Europe. The greens are a little slower. If we want to get more people to play the game of golf, you need to have it more modern facing.
Oh, big slice.
We definitely haven't tested that swing speed.
You need to make it interesting for as many people as possible.
Back to the real world.
I can go to the metaverse. I'm okay.
We made it back.
When I'm done with the game of golf, whenever that is, if I can hand the game off to the next generation and it's in a better place than where I found it, then I've done a good job.
Yeah, should we get to the real stuff, Luke? You ready for it?
Let's get into it.
Last week, Tiger and Rory convened a players-only meeting in Delaware with about 23 of the biggest names on the PGA Tour.
It was more Tiger and Rory leading the discussion, saying, folks, this is what we're doing. Hop aboard.
I think the one thing that came out of it was all the top players on this tour are in agreement and alignment of where we should go going forward.
Where should you go?
I don't think that's for a public forum right now. I think that's between the players and between the executives at the tour to try to sort of manage a way forward.
That seems to suggest that what they're proposing here is going to make them stay committed to the PGA Tour, and in this ever-growing battle with Live Golf, I think that's important.
This year, the spotlight has been on Rory McIlroy more than any other time because of these circumstances that we've never seen before. He has done everything he can to really speak to what he believes is the right thing to do. But I think with that passion also comes that want to perform on the course, to show those guys who are choosing not to be a part of the PGA Tour what they're missing. When time is running out,
for the 19th consecutive year, East Lake Golf Club here in Atlanta marks the end of this tour season. The stakes are as big as they get on the PGA Tour this year, with a $18 million bonus on the line for the winner. Will it be Scottie Scheffler? He's won four times this year, and he was number one on the FedEx Cup points list.
Out on the PGA Tour, there's this underlying race, and that's the race for the FedEx Cup. It's this season-long competition where finishing as high as you possibly can on the leaderboard is going to translate to FedEx Cup points. And the ultimate goal being playing well enough to work your way inside the top 30 in the FedEx Cup standings. And that means that you've punched your ticket to Atlanta for the Tour Championship.
Because the Tour Championship is the culmination of the entire season, players that have played the best up to that point get an advantage. It's the only staggered start in golf. That means that Scottie Scheffler starts with a 2-stroke lead at 10 under par, and then the 2-seed starts at 8 under par, and so on and so forth, all the way down to even par.
I joked a few times this year when people asked, like, what it's like to be number one in the world, I was like, well, I didn't really get any strokes at the beginning of the tournament, so it doesn't really mean too much, but this week, you know, I actually do get some strokes, so my philosophy going into this event is still just to treat it like a 4-day mount, kind of get to ignore the leaderboard and just kind of go out there and try my best. This tournament definitely holds more weight. It's kind of the end of a season-long race, and there's also only 30